Hope you are all fine. All are safe, isn't it, at home? Okay. So I just want to begin with a question. Okay. Do you know anyone who always disagrees with you or fights with you or your friends? Okay. And he or she always does something opposite of what you say. Have you come across anybody like that? Just think for a while. Any girl or a boy, your friend, anybody who has always been against you, or who's always told, or he always opposes for what you say. He doesn't agree with you. Always say no. Okay. So such a person, do you know what they are called? Any idea about such a person? Have you all come across? You all must have thought, isn't it? Somebody must have come to your mind. You know, such people are called, they have a name, okay? So that kind of a person is called a what? Rebel. What are they called? Rebel. You know what a rebel is? Let me make it even more clear. A rebel is a person who opposes or fights. See, that's why I give the symbol. Okay, the one who fights against something, the one who opposes, the one who says no for whatever you say, the one who always does the opposite, the one who disagrees. Okay, such a person is called who? Is called a rebel. Okay, now listen to me very carefully, because you all do not have the textbook, you know, I have put it on a chart. Okay, the whole poem is written on a chart, and this poem is in your honeycomb book, and it is the second poem called the Rebel. Okay, and because you don't have the textbook, I have just put it on the chart just to make it clear for you. So I want all of you to look at this chart, and we are going to see a person, a rebel. Okay, written by E.J. Enright. Who has written it? E.J. Enright is the poet who has written this beautiful poem. And you know, it is nice to read. I just want you to listen to it very carefully. Now let's see what this rebel is doing. Okay, you must have thought about somebody else. You must have thought about a rebel. But we're going to see to a rebel in this poem. Okay, are you all ready, children? Yeah, I'm going to read it out one by one, line by line, couplet by couplet, and then I will be explaining to you. Okay, come on. When everybody has short hair, the rebel lets his hair grow long. See the opposite? Everybody in your class maybe are having short hair. Okay, let me first introduce somebody to you. See, who do they don't listen to? Or who do they oppose? They oppose an authoritative figure. Authoritative figure means maybe your parents, maybe your teachers, or maybe your principal, whoever has got the power, okay? So that authoritative figure, when somebody opposes, maybe they oppose you too, so they are also called a rebel. So that kind of a person only we are talking about. So the first line says, when everybody has short hair, the rebel has long hair, isn't it? Yes or no? Yeah. See, everybody in your class, maybe they're all having short hair, but you know the rebel says, no. Because you all are having short hair, I'm going to have long hair. So that's what he says in the first one. Let's see what he does in the second one. When everybody has long hair, the rebel cuts his hair short. See, the opposite he does. Now all of them are having long hair. You all grow the hair. What the rebel does, he cuts his hair short. He doesn't want to be the same as the others. He wants to show himself very different. Isn't it? See now? Yes. Now next comes, when everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. Yeah, everybody is talking to each other. You all are discussing about a topic, you all are talking about something, you all are talking to the teacher maybe. What does the rebel do? He just keeps his mouth shut. He doesn't want to talk a word. He doesn't say a word. Okay. When nobody talks during the lesson, the rebel creates a listening to the teacher. Now he doesn't want to listen. He creates what? A disturbance. So that is another one. Okay, next one. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel remarks on the need for rain. Now all of you all see summertime, you know, most of you will like summertime because one is holidays. Second one, you will be allowed to play. There will be no rain. If there is no rain, of course you will go to play. But you know what the rebel says? All of you all are praising the sun. But the rebel says, no, I want rain. See how it is? The opposite of what? Of what? Of what the others say. He always wants to be different. When everybody is greeting the rain, the rebel regrets the absence of sun, it seems. See? Now, maybe you like rain and you're greeting the rain. Oh, after a long time there's rain. The farmers also greet the rain. Yeah, they want rain. You too want rain sometimes. Rain is very important, isn't it? So, when you are greeting the rain, you know what the rebel does? He regrets. He says, oh, I feel the sun would be better. He feels that the sun is not there. Okay? Next one. When everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and reads a book. Okay, I think I've come to the third paragraph. I had to go there on top. Anyway, it's okay. We will go on top later on. Okay, I'll finish up with this. When everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and reads a book, it seems. So, what happens? Now, everybody is at home. Everybody goes to the meeting. Maybe you are going to school. But the rebel doesn't want to go. He wants to sit at home and read the book. Now come on, we go to the second paragraph actually. This is the first one and this is the second one. Ma'am has explained the third paragraph. I'm sorry for what has happened. But still, we will be going to the second one because the poem is something similar to each other. Okay. When everybody wears a uniform, the rebel dresses in fantastic clothes. Okay. Now, when all of them are wearing uniform, you are all wearing uniform, right? You know what the rebel does? He wears fantastic clothes. Fantastic clothes means fancy clothes. He wants to come in colorless when all are in uniform. Okay, when everybody wears fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses soberly. Now all of you all are in a very grand manner. All are going for a party. All party wear you all are wearing. But you know what the rebel does? He doesn't want to wear that. Very decently in a simple manner comes. So that is soberly. The meaning of soberly is very simply, it's very decently dressed. Next, in the company of dog lovers, the rebel expresses the preference for cats, it seems. See? Now all will be talking about dogs. All of y'all are dog lovers maybe. All get together, you talk about dogs. And this fellow, he will express a preference for cats because he's always the opposite, right? Now see the next one. In the company of cat lovers, the rebel puts in a good word for dogs. Now in the company of cat lovers, now he's among the company. Company means a group of people, okay? So he's among the group of people who are talking about cats. First group of people were talking about dogs. He gave preference. Preference means he preferred, he wanted to know about, he gave preference for or he expresses more love for the cats. But here what he does, among the cat lovers, he's showing more preference or he puts in a good word. Puts in a good word means says something about dogs. So he's talking something about the dogs. See, everything is opposite. Whatever he does is like opposite, okay? When everybody stays at home and reads a book, the rebel goes to the meeting. See here, when everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and reads a book, isn't it? Now see this next one. When everybody stays at home and reads a book, the rebel goes to the meeting, isn't it? Now I told you, y'all went to school, he wants to stay at home. Now y'all want to stay at home, he wants to go to the meeting. Okay. Yeah, when somebody is offering something, or when somebody is talking to you, or he or she is giving you something. You know, you accept it. You say, yes, please, I can take it up. Yes, please, you can. But what does the rebel do? He says, no, thank you, I don't want. No, thank you, he says. Okay. Next is, when somebody says, no, thank you, the rebel says, yes, please. Now, when somebody is asking for, when somebody is saying, when somebody refuses something, no, I don't want to. When somebody says that, you know, the rebel says, yes, please, please give me. See?
Yes.
Next is, if it is very good that we have rebels. Now comes the poet's real, the real picture. He conveys something. He says, yeah, it is very good that we have rebels. Sometimes rebels are genuine also. Genuine means they oppose for a good reason also. Sometimes they stand for good reasons also. Genuine reason. Genuine means good reasons also. They stand for sometimes. So when you can't talk about something, or when you have the fear, you know, when another person who is a rebel, he is bold enough. He's got that boldness to stand for you. So that kind of a rebel is always good.
Yeah, he says, yes, it is very good that we have rebels for a good cause,
not for a bad cause. He does not mean a bad cause, for a good cause, he says. You may not find it very good to be one, but too much of rebelling, or too much of opposing, and too much of disagreement also will not be liked by everyone, isn't it? So that's the message that he wants to convey. Who has conveyed this message? Do you know who the poet is?
The poet is D.J. Enright.
Now a few meanings are given on the board. Okay. Now I just want to bring in the key points. Can I bring in the key points? Who do you call a rebel, children? Who do you call a rebel? The one who does not conform to the norms, societal norms. The one who does not conform. Conform means who does not want to follow any rules. Such a person is what? Is a rebel. And you know, sometimes these rebels always keep questioning and questioning and questioning. Have you heard them questioning? Yeah, when they oppose, you know, they start questioning too much. So, such a person is also called a rebel. So, you have seen the key points of a rebel. I just want to bring in something more for you. I want to tell you how the poem is. How the poem is written. The poetic devices. Poetic devices means to make the poem a little more attractive, you know. The poets use this. And let's see what style he has brought into the poem. He has brought in some style over here. So I just want to write that style on the board. You know, that style is, he has brought the poem. It's a very casual poem. Not a very formal poem. Formal means what? Romba formula, you know, respectful ilama. It's like a very casual poem. A very informal poem. Informal or a very casual poem. Okay. And next is the tone. I just want to tell you the tone. Tone is, it's a very humorous poem. You laugh, you know, when you read the poem, everything is opposite and opposite and opposite, right? And cat lovers, he talks about dogs. Dog lovers, he talks about cats. So it is very humorous. Humorous means what? Very funny, yes. The tone is very funny. Humorous. Okay. Humorous, okay. And then what the form it is in? It has got, see, 15 couplets. So the two lines is called a couplet. Okay. You know what a couplet is? A couplet is a pair of rhyming lines. I'll just write it down. A pair of rhyming lines. Okay. I think you can see it. Okay.
rhyming lines. So this is called a, this one thing is called a couplet. Those two lines come under a couplet. Okay? So there are around 15 couplets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 couplets in this poem. And you know, each couplet is giving the opposite meaning. Okay? So you must have seen, everything has got the opposite meaning. Short hair, very well children. So I hope that you will read the poem, and when you read the poem, it's very humorous and funny. So thank you for listening. And one more thing is, I just want you to, I give you two questions. I just want you to think about those questions. Okay? The first question is, listen very carefully. Can a rebel be good? Can a rebel be good? You have to think. Yeah, according to me, the rebel can be good. I said some genuine reasons, the rebel will be good also sometimes. He stands for you and me. Sometimes for a good cause when he stands, yes, the rebel can be good too. Okay, how can being a rebel affect you? How can being a rebel affect you? Okay, you just think of that and answer these two questions. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you, children.